Hello everyone, this is the third video on well logging, and I am going to discuss porosity and permeability in this video. If you have not watched the previous video, please go watch and then come to this video. Okay, so let's get started. So what is porosity? It is basically the fraction of total volume of rock that is not occupied by the solid constituent. Okay, the fraction of total volume of rock that is not occupied by solid constituent. So the bulk volume of reservoir, what will be? It is the A into H, area into height of the reservoir, area obtained from the seismic data and thickness of the reservoir rock. So the relative amount of pore spaces to the bulk volume is denoted by porosity phi. Okay, the relative amount of pore spaces to the bulk volume is denoted by porosity phi. And basically what is porosity is the fraction of bulk volume. Okay, and which is occupied by the pore volume. So in other words, we can write phi is equal to V pore upon V bulk. From here, we can write V pore is equal to V bulk into phi, and what we have got from V bulk, A into H. So with the help of this, you can calculate the volume of pore spaces. V pore is equal to A, area, which we will get from seismic data, H in thickness of the reservoir, and phi is the porosity. Now what is saturation? If I have talked about porosity, what is saturation? Saturation is basically if I talk about water saturation. So in the porosity, how much there is a volume occupied by water? This is water saturation. Okay, how much volume it is occupied by hydrocarbon? It is hydrocarbon saturation. So, and in any reservoir, the saturation of water plus saturation of hydrocarbon equals to 1. And how we will get the volume of hydrocarbons? Basically, VH is equal to A into H into phi and 1 minus SW. Remember this, okay? So, you get what I have tried to tell you. Again, I repeat, what is porosity? Porosity of rock is the fraction of volume of space between the solid particles of the rock to the total rock volume. अगर जैसे हम बोले कि जो स्पेसेस की हम बात कर रहे हैं, दिस इंक्लूड ऑल पोर्स, क्रैक्स, वर्क्स, इंटर एंड इंट्रा क्रिस्टलाइन स्पेसेस, ऑल दिस स्पेसेस, ओके, विच इज नॉट ऑक्यूपाइड बाय सॉलिड कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स, एंड वी विल रिप्रेजेंट इट इन फ्रैक्शंस. एंड इट शुड बी नोटेड दैट द पोरोसिटी डज नॉट गिव एनी इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट कंसर्निंग पोर साइजेस, देयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन और देयर डिग्री ऑफ कनेक्टिविटी. I have already told you, if we talk about the degree of connectivity, that is related to permeability and what are the pore sizes, we will not get this information from porosity. Now you can see the thickness of the reservoir zone. There is a term called net sand, and the net sand, what is net sand? It is the thickness of clean, permeable and hydrocarbon containing sand. So basically net sand is, it is the thickness of a clean sandstone. There is no shale. The clean sandstone, that thickness is called net sand. Try to remember these things. And what is gross sand? If there is some kind of impurity or basically shale is present or other anything is present, then we will call it gross sand. So the thickness of sand in the reservoir zone, irrespective of whether it is clean, its permeability or water is saturation is, whatever its saturation is, then we will call it gross sand. And the net to gross ratio is used to present the quality of reservoir zone. Try to remember, the net to gross ratio is used to present the quality of reservoir zone. Now there is a term, this may not ask in your examination, but it can be asked in the interviews. What is this stoichic? I don't know how to pronounce this, but it is stock tank oil originally in place. So before knowing this, what is this stock tank oil originally in place, you have to know something else. Okay. So what is oil in place and what is gas in place? So there is a term called oil in place and gas in place. And basically, what are their formulas? This is 7758 A into H 51 minus SW BBL. This is barrels basically. And where this formula come, you don't know, don't have to get into that. Or gas in place, where this formula comes, why there is 7758, all these things are not important, but you know what is this oil in place and gas in place. What happens is that when oils are originally at place, they are at different temperature and pressure conditions. When they are raised to the surface, their temperature and pressure condition is changed. And why, what happens is that basically due to compressibility of oil and basically due to mostly because of the compressibility of gas, they occupy different volume at surface pressure and temperature conditions. So and these condition which are at surface, these are called stock tank what it is basically stock tank oil originally in place. At the originally when the oil and gas are not extracted, they are at different pressure and temperature conditions. Okay, but when they are raised to the surface, their volume changes because of the different pressure and temperature conditions. What happens is that the compressibility of oil and especially gas and their coefficient of expansion with temperature means that they will occupy different volume at the surface. Because of the different pressure and temperature condition at the surface, they will occupy different volume. And why they will occupy different volume? Because of their compressibility of oil and gas. So for this reason, the reserves are often corrected for changes in temperature and pressure conditions. So after correction, we will referring to the terms what is called stoichiometric and basically stock tank oil originally in place. This is done after this term is given after correction. Kya hota hai ki jaise jaise oil aur gas ko hum temperature jab wo originally reservoir mein rehte hain tab hum term use karte hain originally oil in reservoir OOIP. But jab wo pressure aur temperature condition unki change hoti hai, jaise jaise wo surface pe laye jate hain, tab unka volume या तो एक्सपेंड हो चुका होता है या तो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हो चुका होता है. तो वो जो एक्सपेंशन और कॉन्ट्रैक्शन हो रहा है वो डिफरेंट प्रेशर और टेम्परेचर कंडीशंस की वजह से हो रहा है, तब हम वो टर्म यूज़ करते हैं STOOIP स्टॉक टैंक ऑयल ओरिजिनल इन प्लेस और STGOIP स्टॉक टैंक गैस ओरिजिनल इन प्लेस, तब ये टर्म हम सरफेस पे यूज़ करते हैं. ओके, आई थिंक दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. देखो अब एक चीज़ और जान लेते हैं. जैसे हम ऑयल को सरफेस प्रेशर कंडीशंस पे ले आते हैं, उनमें एक्सपेंशन हो सकता है, रिडक्शन हो सकता है. अब ये जो हो रहा है, इसको ये जो चेंज आ रहा है, इसको हम एक टर्म से रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं जिसका नाम है फॉर्मेशन वॉल्यूम फैक्टर. और यहाँ पे ऑयल के लिए फॉर्मेशन वॉल्यूम फैक्टर है बी नॉट, और ये रिप्रेजेंट करता है रेशियो ऑफ, जिसे यहाँ पर लिखा भी हुआ है, रेशियो ऑफ वॉल्यूम ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड मास ऑफ ऑयल एट रिजर्वायर कंडीशंस to that at the stock tank oil conditions. Okay, during production. Let me repeat, जो changes हो रहे हैं उसको हम represent कैसे करते हैं, वो हम लोग represent करते हैं oil formation volume factor से. और ये होता है ratio of volume of standard mass of oil at reservoir condition. Reservoir condition मतलब originally, अभी हम लोगों ने कुछ extract नहीं किया, कुछ भी उससे कुछ किया नहीं है. To that at the stock tank condition, i.e. during production. उस वक्त क्या कंडीशन होगी, उसका रेशियो है ओके बी नॉट. एंड ओवरऑल अब ये जो स्टोइपिक है और स्टॉक टैंक ऑयल ओरिजिनल इन प्लेस, इसका फॉर्मूला बनता है 7758 एच 51 माइनस एसडब्ल्यू अपॉन बी नॉट. और ये बेसिकली एक तरह से जो बी नॉट है ये करेक्शन फैक्टर है जो चेंजेस आए उसकी वजह से. Okay, I think you have understand this term. And STGOIP, ST means stock tank gas oil originating place. And this also formula is given, it is given cubic per feet, cubic feet. So I think you have understand this term. And if you don't, watch this video again. And if still you don't, then comment, I will discuss it again. So porosity are also represented by porosity units, and 100 porosity units means 100%. And as I've said, porosity is equal to V pore upon V bulk. And if I have to write, V pore can be written as V bulk minus V matrix. And volume of matrix can be written as weight of dry to the density of the matrix. Okay. One more thing I have already told you, but porosity does not give any information about connecting concerning pores, pore sizes and their distribution and their degree of connectivity. I have already told you this. So let's get forward. I've already discussed these things. And let's come about carbonate rock. What happens? In the previous video, I have told you that carbonate rocks can have a good porosity, but there is generally low permeability. So pores are unconnected. And when the pores are connected, the permeability will be low. And what is now come to the types of porosity? There is a term called total porosity. Total porosity means it includes all the spaces as defined above, consists of all the void spaces, pores, channels, fissure, works between the solid components. Okay, it includes all the pore spaces, channels, fissure. And what is this channel fissures? I will show you a figure, then you will know it. So phi t barabar equals to Vt minus Vs upon Vt. Vp is the volume of all empty spaces. And Vs is the volume of solid materials. And phi t is equal to phi 1 plus phi 2. Phi 1 is primary porosity, phi 2 is secondary porosity. And primary, what is primary porosity? It is intergranular or intercrystalline porosity. It is because of the arrangements of grains or all those things. This primary porosity is not related to fracture or cracks. This is the fracture or cracks. They are related to secondary porosity. So the primary porosity depends upon the shape, size, and arrangement of solid minerals. Okay, example is clastic rock. And what is secondary porosity? It is made up of works, fissures, cracks, as I already told you, that are caused by mechanical forces. Rocks of chemical or organic origin, porosity resulting from diagenesis. These are the example of secondary porosity. And what is interconnected porosity? Basically, what happens that phi connect is made up of only those spaces which are in communication. That means it considers only the connected channels. Let me give you example of pumice stone. It has phi connect 0. Why? There are no interconnecting channels. It has a porosity of 50%. Its total porosity is 50%. But if I ask you what is interconnected porosity in pumice stone, it is 0 because there are no interconnecting channels. So you can look this figure. These are basically grains and this is channel and this is pores. So total porosity includes all the spaces, channels, pores, fissures. Okay, you can see this. Okay. Now what is potential porosity? Another type. So part of interconnected porosity, diameter of the connecting channel is large enough to permit fluid to flow. So interconnected porosity ka ek example hai potential porosity, so that the diameter of the connecting channel is large enough to permit fluid to flow. There's no rocket science in that. Just try to remember the definition. Now effective porosity, very important, because this is the term we are going to use mostly in log analysis. So effective porosity, it is the porosity that is accessible to the free fluids, and it excludes the non-connecting channels, non-connected porosity, the volume occupied by clay-bound water or the clay hydration water surrounding the clay particles. Basically, what happens is that कि इफेक्टिव पोरोसिटी वी आर ओनली इंटरेस्टेड इन दोज पार्ट विच इज एक्सेसिबल टू फ्री फ्लोर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू गो आई विल लेटर वेन आई विल एक्सप्लेन न्यूट्रॉन लॉ देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन ऑल दोज थिंग्स. बट राइट नाउ नो दिस दैट क्ले हैज़ अ बाउंड वाटर. आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो क्ले हैज़ अ बाउंड वाटर एंड इट हैज़ एन इफेक्ट ऑन द लॉग रिस्पॉन्स. सो द इफेक्टिव पोरोसिटी इज वॉट? इट इज द पोरोसिटी दैट इज एक्सेसिबल टू फ्री फ्लोट्स एंड इट एक्सक्लूड्स ऑल द बाउंड वाटर रिलेटेड पोरोसिटी, हाइड्रेशन वाटर रिलेटेड पोरोसिटी. वी आर ओनली इंटरेस्टेड इन द फ्री फ्लूट पोरोसिटी एंड दिस टर्म इज मोस्टली यूज इन लॉग एनालिसिस. यू विल सी इट लेटर. देर इज ऑल्सो टर्म कॉल्ड इंटर क्रिस्टल पोरोसिटी. वॉट इज इंटर क्रिस्टल पोरोसिटी? माइक्रो पोरोसिटी एग्जिस्टिंग अलॉन्ग द इंटर क्रिस्टलाइन बाउंड्रीज यूजली इन कार्बोनेट रॉक्स. ओके, इट्स अ माइक्रो पोरोसिटी एंड इट इज यूजली फाउंड इन कार्बोनेट रॉक्स. सो वॉट इज इंटर क्रिस्टल पोरोसिटी? इट इज अ माइक्रो पोरोसिटी एग्जिस्टिंग अलॉन्ग इंटर क्रिस्टलाइन बाउंड्रीज यूजली इन कार्बोनेट रॉक्स. जस्ट नो द डेफिनेशन. And there is also term fenestral porosity. It is also called bird's eye porosity. It is also found in carbonate rocks, and these are usually associated with algal mats. What is algal mats? Basically, organic matter. So there are some range of the porosity values for the rocks. So unconsolidated sand, definitely they will have generally high porosity, and as the consolidation becomes, as the rock become consolidated or become compacted, the porosity will reduce. You can try to imagine as the pore species are becoming less and solid constituent is becoming more, so the porosity will definitely reduce. Shales is a very variable porosity. Clay is also, limestone, massive limestone, low porosity. Dolomite, 10 to 30, chalk and granite has very less porosity. Basalt has, at the same time, has very less porosity. And you just have a quick look about these values and try to remember them. There's also a term called moldic porosity. So it is a type of secondary porosity that is created through the dissolution of pre-existing constituent of a rock, such as shale rock fragments or grains. So it is a type of secondary porosity, okay, and it is created through the dissolution of pre-existing constituents. What happens that it is a type of dissolution porosity, and it is also found in carbonate rocks, and that result because of the molds of original grain or fossil remains. Okay, molds are basically a kind of hollow shape, and molds of original grains or fossil remains, because of that there is a term called dissolution porosity, and it is usually found in carbonate rocks. And here the pore species preserve the shape or the mold of dissolution material. Okay, there is also a term called interparticle porosity, porosity between the particles. It is seldom preserved because porosity lost by cementation. Intraparticle porosity within the particles of the grains. Fenestral porosity, I have already discussed it. Okay, what is shelter porosity? So it is a type of primary interparticle porosity, and it is created by shattering effect of relatively large sedimentary particles. What happens that these large sedimentary particles basically block and so that they prevent the filling of pore spaces beneath them by finer clastic particles. So kya hota hai ki ye jo large sedimentary blocks hain, वो जो लार्ज सेडिमेंट पार्टिकल्स हैं वो ब्लॉक करते हैं फाइनर पार्टिकल को सेटल होने में. उससे जो हमारी पोरोसिटी बनती है उसको हम लोग बोलते हैं शेल्टर पोरोसिटी. शैटरिंग इफेक्ट इज देयर. यू कैन सी द फिगर हियर. देयर आर सम बेसिक पोरोसिटी टाइप्स: इंटर पार्टिकल, इंट्रा पार्टिकल, इंटर क्रिस्टल, मोल्डिक, फेनेस्ट्रल, सेल्टर, ग्रोथ फ्रेमवर्क. दीज आर और फैब्रिक सिलेक्टिव. And there are some non-fabric selective, which is fractured porosity due to fracture, channel works, and cavern. You can see it. Let me zoom this for you. So interparticle, intraparticle, intercrystal, moldic. You can see the round shapes, fenestral, shelter. These large parts are blocking, so that blocking the final particles, shattering effect, which is found in shelter porosity. And here is fracture, non-fabric selective, channels, works, cavern. Okay. Try to take a view of this. Now let's discuss more about carbonates. So carbonate, what happens that carbonate have a relatively very high porosity, but the permeability is low. I have already told you in previous video, try to remember. So the permeability is low as the pores and works they make up the pore structure are unconnected. Okay. And there are four ways by which we can measure the porosity. These are buoyancy, helium, porosimetry, fluid saturation, mercury, porosimetry. Just remember names, do not have to go into details. They are not so important in terms of examination. Now let's start permeability. So the permeability of rock is a measure of ease with which the rock will permit the passage of fluids. Permeability basically rock kitna easily allow karta hai fluid ko flow karne mein, that is the measurement of that is permeability. And when there are two or more immiscible fluids fluid phases flowing, then we will use the term relative permeability. If there is only one fluid, then we will use the term absolute permeability. And if there are more than one fluids, then we will use the term relative permeability. And this the equation is governed by Navier-Stokes equation. It is very complex equation. So let's get forward. The main permeability formula used in the oil industry is the Darcy formula. And how it is? Q equals to K into Pi minus P naught upon mu into L. So it is for a single fluid. Q is the flow rate, P is the outlet pressure, Pi is the inlet pressure, and mu is the dynamic viscosity of the fluid. K is the permeability of the sample, and its unit is Darcy or meter square. Sometimes units are also asked in gate examination. And there are so some things you should know. A permeable rock must have a connected porosity. Okay, the higher the porosity in general, the higher the porosity, the higher the permeability. Because we have seen previous, sometimes there is porosity but no permeability. But in general, the higher the porosity, the higher the permeability. The smaller the grains, the smaller the pores, and the pore throats and lower will be the permeability, obviously. So in general, we in oil industry use the term 1 milli Darcy. And permeability is generally anisotropic in rock because of the depositional effect and because of the in situ stress field in the crust. Generally, the permeability is anisotropic, and I accept that you know what is anisotropic. So if the rock contains one fluid, the permeability is maximum and we will call it absolute permeability. The most obvious control on permeability is porosity. This is because larger the porosity means there may be many more paths and broader pathways for fluid to flow. That is why we say that if the porosity is high, then permeability will generally be high. So it's possible to have very high porosity without any permeability, as I've already told you, at all, as in the case of pumice stone. We have seen it previously since there are no interconnected channels. So the controlling factor, therefore, it's not the porosity itself, but the size of pores and connecting channels. Okay, we have discussed so many times the size of pores and connecting channels are very important. So the viability of reservoir depends upon three critical parameters: porosity, permeability, and hydrocarbon saturation. In the first video, I have discussed that what is a reservoir. It is a porous and permeable body which may contain water or hydrocarbon, from where water or hydrocarbon can be extracted. So the critical parameters are porosity and permeability and hydrocarbon saturation. That is what we are mostly interested in well logging, or how much porosity is occupied by hydrocarbons. Okay, the pore fluids are subjected to capillary forces at the solid-liquid interface. The liquid may be attracted or repelled, and the liquid that is attracted is said to wet the solid surface. So, a reservoir can quite well contain two or even three fluids, water, oil, and gas. We use the concept of relative permeability. When there are more than one fluid, we use the concept of relative permeability. And the flow of individual fluids interfere, and their effective permeabilities are less than absolute permeability. And how we will write relative permeability? Basically, relative permittivity is the ratio of effective permeability of oil and the absolute permeability. Basically, KRO here represent KRO represent the relative permeability of oil, and it is the ratio of effective permeability of oil to the absolute permeability. So KW and KR here effective permeabilities. Okay, relative permeability, effective permeability upon absolute permittivity. So in this video, I end here, and I have discussed porosity and permeability. If you have not understand anything, if you have doubt, comment section mein batao, we will discuss that. And if you like the video, then share it to your friends. And if you like this initiative, give your suggestions. How can I improve it? Whatever your questions are. Okay, thank you. मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट वीडियो में.